dramatic victory. Now!
Destroy! Come on!
Ready!
Crush him!
Now's our chance!
Looking good!
Right here. Ready.
Beat him down! up.
You can do it.
Looking good.
Crush up.
Thank you.
Hello everyone, and welcome to another video of Wizard Soon. So for today, finally, the Legendary Arena Gauntlet event has been released. So for this event, it's actually located rather at the event instead of at Legendary Arena. It's an interesting choice by Dana, but nevertheless, a quick breakdown of my personal views about this event. It's an event that is geared vastly towards the paid players, where they spam a lot of the gems to gather as many sync pairs as possible. So for free players, like my baby account which is currently showing, your mileage may vary. It really depends on the amount of the sync pairs that you have, and that will lead you to the amount of distance that you can, amount of the legendary arena battles that you can go. So for this Gauntlet event, there will be three events, which is the Cobalion, Azelf, and the Entei. So the focus type will basically be Fire, Bug, and Water. The moment where you are done with the event, all three Pokemon that you use, be fainted or still remaining, will no longer be able to use. So for example, right now in behind I'm playing, it is the second part of the legendary event where currently I'm only using 2 sync pairs. At the end of the battle, a total of 14 sync pairs, which is basically 3 times 4 plus 2, will be recorded. So all these 14 sync pairs, you will not be able to use anymore. So one thing to take note, this legendary arena take in groups of 3. So you must complete in any order of your preference, the Cobalion, Azelf, and then Entei before they are reset for you to re-challenge again. So you will not be able to challenge Cobalion 3 times in a row. That will not be allowed. You'll only be allowed to re-challenge that once you complete the entire list. So one more thing to take note is that at the end of the legendary battle, be it your Pokemon is alive or fainted at the end of the battle, those sync pairs will not be able to use at all. So good planning beforehand on your sync pairs and your teams, which is I think that's why they have 30 teams for you to play with already for the latest update. So you can plan your team ahead on how you wanted to plan with your teams beforehand before you go ahead with this challenge. So right now it is just a quick trial play on my baby account before I will move it to the main challenge on my main account. So With that, once I really get a feel of how this event is like, I will do this challenge on my main account to see how far I'll go. So with that, this is basically my comments about this event with the few things to take note. If you have any good strategy you wanted to share, feel free to comment down below. And if you like my content, please feel free to subscribe, like and share the video. And I will see you guys in the next video. See ya!